Back in 1969, it was the response of the RUC and the B Specials to growing civil unrest that led to the deployment of the British Army on Northern Ireland streets. At first, they were welcomed in nationalist as well as loyalist areas. But the IRA shot dead the first British soldier, 20-year-old Robert Curtis, in February 1971. And from then on, Republican paramilitaries considered them legitimate targets. Unionists always saw them differently.
They were there in a role which was to help end the civil conflict and bring peace onto the streets. In many respects, they were holding the line against terrorism. They had, I believe, the full support of the unionist community in doing so.
At different stages of the Troubles, the British Army suffered huge losses, as at Narrow Water near Newry in 1979, when the IRA blew up 18 soldiers, and at Ballygawley in 1988, when an IRA bomb killed 8 soldiers on a bus. Their blackest chapter was in Derry in 1972, when the parachute regiment shot dead 14 civilians. It was in Derry City too that a 23-year-old soldier, Corporal Michael Ryan, was shot dead in 1974. His grieving parents were Catholics of Irish extraction. One of the 16-year-olds convicted in relation to his killing is now a Sinn Féin councillor.
We're living in different times and I'm a different person now, and I can understand what those young soldiers must have thought coming here, because this was a very, very, very war zone city.
Although the peace process stalled and stuttered many times since, it was the Good Friday Agreement of 1998 that paved the way for an end to Operation Banner.
It's a transition, a much more subtle transition than some sort of war being over. The security challenges that exist today do not require people like me and my troops to provide the support to the PSNI that we had to in the past.
There would be a wide range of opinion about the role played by the British Army in the course of Operation Banner. But even in this divided society, there would be widespread relief that the days of British soldiers killing and being killed on Northern Ireland's streets are over. Tommy Gorman, RTE News, Belfast.